वेलकम बैक टू केबीरा एकेडमी ऑनलाइन स्टडी चैनल। मायसेल्फ रामेश मौर्या, योर फिजिक्स टीचर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द रिलेशन बिटवीन लीनियर वेलोसिटी एंड एंगुलर वेलोसिटी। सो व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन एंगुलर वेलोसिटी एंड लीनियर वेलोसिटी दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिराइव। फॉर दिस कंसिडर एन ऑब्जेक्ट which is revolving around a circular path of a circle whose radius is r. In t time, it describes the arc AB of length L. So, in same time t, it will also describe the angle theta. You can see here, in same time it is coming from A to B, so it is forming arc AB of length L and it is forming theta angle. So let the linear velocity is V and angular velocity is omega. So linear velocity v is equal to distance upon time, we know. So v is equal to distance, it will be L and time is t. So v is equal to L upon t. Let this is equation number one. And angular velocity, angular velocity equal to angle upon time. So angular velocity omega is equal to theta upon t. You know, the angular velocity, the angle derived in unit time. So angular velocity omega is equal to theta upon t. But we know that but theta is equal to L upon R. So from here L is equal to R into theta. Now we will put this value in equation number one. So from equation 1, v is equal to r into theta, because l is equal to r into theta, so l is here r into theta upon this one t. So v is equal to r into this one theta upon t, and v is equal to r into theta upon t. We know that this is omega. So this is the relation between linear velocity and angular velocity. From here we conclude that linear velocity equal to r means radius into angular velocity. So this is the relation between linear velocity and angular velocity. Now we will discuss some more thing like time period and frequency. So time period, the time period of an object in circular motion is defined as the time taken to complete one revolution. Means, suppose a body is rotating on this circular path. So, from and it is starting its motion from A. So, after starting its motion from A and again it comes at point A, that will be one revolution. So, the time taken to complete one revolution is known as time period. So, time period, time taken to one revolution. And frequency, the revolution in unit time. Means, suppose a body is revolving 10 times in 1 second, so the frequency will be 10. So, the number of revolution made in 1 second, or we can say unit time, is known as frequency. So, today we discuss mainly relation between linear velocity and angular velocity. That's all. Thank you.